Il faut manger pour vivre et non pas vivre pour manger. Il faut manger pour vivre et non pas vivre pour manger, says Molière in L'Avare. You have to eat in order to live and not live in order to eat, which comes from Socrate, the famous Greek philosopher. So food is at the heart of French culture. We talk about it all the time, and French cuisine is very famous all around the world. And French cooking with French recipes can, however, be very complicated because of its obscure vocabulary. So today I'm going to show you all these verbs about cooking. Well, not all the verbs because there are so many. So we're going to focus on six of them. And we're going to focus on the verbs about cooking in a pan. I will cover the oven and preparation in other lessons because it would take forever. This is what you will learn today. If you're a beginner, only focus on the six main verbs. This is enough for today. If you're intermediate, you can add in the examples that I will talk about. And if you're advanced, fantastic, félicitations. You can learn everything from this lesson. As usual, this video lesson comes with a free written lesson in PDF that you can get on commeunefrancaise.com. There you get vocabulary and extra vocabulary, links, extra resources to cultural elements that I don't have the time to mention here. You can print the PDF, take notes, keep it with you. It is completely free. Also, you have a free email in French with an introduction about what we're going to talk about during the lesson of the day, all in French to practice your reading skills. How to get these two free resources? If you're watching this on YouTube, click on the link below the video to get access to it. And once you're on Comme une Française, click on the button below the video and leave your first name and email, and you will have access to them immediately. Both are completely free. Bonjour, c'est Géraldine. Bienvenue sur Comme une Française. C'est parti. Take your pen and your notebook. Let's learn some French that matters together. C'est parti. Mijoter is our first verb for today. Mijoter. What do you think that means? Mijoter. It means to simmer, to stew. And usually when we talk about verbs about cooking in French, we're going to add faire at the beginning of it. So faire plus le verbe de cuisine. Faire, and then we add the verb about cooking. So for example, if you're reading a recipe with the verb mijoter, it would be written faire mijoter 4 heures à feu doux. Faire mijoter 4 heures à feu doux. So let simmer for 4 hours at a low heat. Faire mijoter 4 heures à feu doux. This is typically what will be in a French recipe. So we say faire mijoter, but you can also say laisser mijoter. Laisser mijoter is like faire mijoter. You leave it to simmer. But you can also put it directly, and this way you have to put what's cooking first. For example, le bœuf bourguignon mijote depuis ce matin. Le bœuf bourguignon mijote depuis ce matin. The bœuf bourguignon is simmering, has been simmering since this morning. Okay, so you don't have to put faire there. Le bœuf bourguignon mijote depuis ce matin, it's direct. But to stew or to simmer has also a second meaning in French. Mijoter has a second meaning. It can mean to plot, to scheme, or just to think very hard. For example, qu'est-ce que tu mijotes? Qu'est-ce que tu mijotes? Je réfléchis à la façon de réparer le four. Je réfléchis à la façon de réparer le four. What are you thinking so hard about? Or what are you plotting? Qu'est-ce que tu mijotes? Je réfléchis à la façon de réparer le four. I'm thinking about how to fix the oven. So you see, it's all about thinking hard. And you can see the meaning with to simmer and to stew. A synonym we have for mijoter is also mitonner. Mitonner, it's less used, but it can be used in the same way. For example, Alexandra mitonne une soupe de poireaux. Alexandra mitonne une soupe de poireaux. Alexandra is cooking a soup of a leek soup. Alexandra mitonne une soupe de poireaux. So you can imagine here that she's really putting her heart into it. She wants to make it well. It takes a bit of time, but she really wants to do it, and it's going to smell good and taste good. You have everything around mitonner. If you're advanced, you might have heard a kind of slang that sounds like mitonner. Well, it sounds exactly the same, but it's not written the same. Mitonner, it means mentir in French as well. Mitonner means mentir in French, to lie. Mentir is to lie. Mitonner is a kind of slang that is not used everywhere, but it's known because mito means a lie in slang. Okay. And you can also know another synonym for that in slang, it's pipoter, because pipo is the flute that you can play when you're saying lies. So pipoter and mitonner are slang for to lie, but if you're intermediate, you can forget about that. Just in case this is going too fast for you can always pause the video to take notes. Remember, we're in no hurry. The second verb for today is bouillir. Bouillir. What do you think that means? It's close to its meaning in English. Bouillir is to boil, actually. To boil. Bouillir, to boil. In a recipe, you might read faire bouillir les œufs pendant 5 minutes. Faire bouillir les œufs pendant 5 minutes. Faire bouillir les œufs pendant 5 minutes. Boil the eggs for 5 minutes. If you know French cooking a little bit, you might have heard about broth or stock, which in French is le bouillon. So it's close from bouillir. Le bouillon. Le bouillon is broth or stock. And also, we have an expression with bouillir, which is faire bouillir la marmite. Faire bouillir la marmite, it means to bring home the bacon in English. Faire bouillir la marmite. For example, chez les Martins, c'est le salaire de Pauline qui fait bouillir la marmite. Chez les Martins, c'est le salaire de Pauline qui fait bouillir la marmite. So, at Martin's house, it's Pauline's income that brings home the bacon, so which makes life easy to live. About bouillir, there was another example that I wanted to give you, which is pocher. Pocher, to poach in English, easy. Pocher, it's a kind of cooking where you use boiling water. So, for example, with pocher, Marie sait très bien pocher les œufs. Marie sait très bien pocher les œufs. Marie knows very well how to do poached eggs. And if you are into cooking, you might have heard of un œuf poché. Un œuf poché is a kind of cooking for an egg that makes it very soft and delicious, but it's a bit tricky to do. Un œuf poché. If you love French food, by the way, you should check out my course Inside of French. It will help you improve your French with my lessons about French cheese and wine. It's a delicious course, which is a fun thing to say, and it will help you also with good manners at a French table, which can be tricky because we have weird French customs. So check out Inside of French if you want to know more about French cuisine and mostly French cheese and wine and French manners at the table and what to talk about when you're sitting at a table with French people. Inside of French. Our third word for today is cuire au bain-marie. Cuire au bain-marie. What do you think that means? I've heard that bain-marie is actually used in English as well, so you might know this already. Un bain is a bath in French as a clue. Un bain, with the un sound, is a bath. Un bain. So actually, for some people who are into cooking, bain-marie can be used in English as well, but I've read during my research that you could use double boiler as well. So the idea is you have a pan with the water in it and you put a second thing, bowl in it, and you can add then water and then what you have to cook, or just to warm up something like food for children very often. So it keeps the temperature even. So that's the trick for cooking. Un bain-marie. And this is something you use on top of for children's food For chocolates as well, very often. For example, you might read in a recipe, faire fondre le chocolat au bain-marie. Faire fondre le chocolat au bain-marie. So here I wanted to show you another verb, which is fondre, and fondre is to melt. Fondre, to melt. It applies to snow and ice as well. It's not just for chocolate. Melt is fondre in French. Faire fondre le chocolat au bain-marie. If you're curious about how names are formed and where they come from, like I am, bain-marie, the marie there, seems to be coming, according to the dictionary, from Marie la Juive, so Marie the Jewish, and she was an alchemist during the 16th century. Marie la Juive was une alchimiste au 16e siècle. Une alchimiste au 16e siècle. So this seems to be where the name comes from, according to my dictionary. Are you still okay? You can pause, remember? Our fourth verb for today is faire revenir. Faire revenir. What do you think that means? Revenir is to come back or to return. You might know that. What do you think faire revenir means? It's very hard to find out. Actually, faire revenir means to brown something. For example, faire revenir les poireaux dans du beurre. Faire revenir les poireaux dans du beurre. To brown the leek in butter. Faire revenir les poireaux dans du beurre. You can also say faire dorer, which means to golden something. Faire dorer or faire blondir as well. Faire blondir. They all roughly mean exactly the same. So you put some butter or oil or something in a pan, and then you put your ingredients and you make them warm and brown. This is the idea behind all these verbs. So we have faire revenir, faire dorer, faire blondir. But we have other ones as well. We have poêler, poêler, yes, like une poêle, poêler. Saisir, to catch, actually, saisir. We also have faire rissoler. Faire rissoler. So this is very often for potatoes. Faire rissoler. Faire sauter. Faire sauter. Again, in the French mind, we have very lots of heat and ingredients like vegetables or meat as well that you can do that with. Faire sauter. And at last, faire frire. Faire frire is to fry. So it implies more oil or more butter, obviously. Faire frire is to fry. So it's a bit different, but it's in the same family as well. Faire frire for to fry. We also have lots of other uses of revenir in the French language. I'm not going to talk about all of them, but one that makes me laugh because students have trouble understanding this one is ne pas en revenir. Ne pas en revenir. It means not believing something. Ne pas en revenir. I should do la liaison, obviously. Ne pas en revenir. Ne pas en revenir. You can hear that I do the, la liaison. Ne pas en revenir. So, we conjugate it, obviously. When we use it, we say, je n'en reviens pas. Je n'en reviens pas. I can't believe it. Je n'en reviens pas. I can't believe it. But as you might know, in everyday spoken French, we remove the ne. So we remove je n'en reviens pas, and then it becomes j'en reviens pas. J'en reviens pas. Obviously, when you're not believing something, the language you will use will be linked to that. So the intention behind it will very obviously be everyday spoken French, which is j'en reviens pas. J'en reviens pas because it's very spontaneous. You have feelings, so you will use this kind of French. J'en reviens pas. I can't believe it. Our fifth word for today, verb actually, is couvrir. Couvrir. What do you think that means? It's very close to the English translation. Couvrir. What do you think? Couvrir is to cover. It's very simple. So you put a lid on something. For example, couvrir et laisser mijoter 2 heures à feu doux. Couvrir et laisser mijoter 2 heures à feu doux. Cover and let it simmer 2 hours at a low heat. couvrir et laisser mijoter 2 heures à feu doux. A lid, I talked about it, is un couvercle, and you can see the same origin there. Couvrir, un couvercle. We have the couve beginning here. Un couvercle, a lid. Another word that we have which is not about cooking is a cover, une couverture for a cover, une couverture. If you want to cover something with something else, it will be recouvrir de quelque chose. Recouvrir de quelque chose is to cover something with something else. If you're advanced, try to work on that. If you're not, it's fine. Recouvrir means to cover something with something else. Yes, we had the re, that doesn't add much sense here, but this is the meaning. Recouvrir is to cover something with something else. And our last verb for today, yes, it's réduire, réduire. What do you think that means, réduire? Réduire is to reduce. It seems to be the same verb in English for cooking. Réduire, to reduce. In French, the definition is faire épaissir par évaporation. Faire épaissir par évaporation. And we usually talk about this for une sauce. We say réduire une sauce. Réduire une sauce. So if you didn't get it because you don't cook much, it means that you have a sauce and you have to make it... you have to reduce the volume by removing the water. So you will let the water evaporate and the sauce will be more tasty. That's the idea of reducing something. Réduire une sauce is that. If you're into cooking, I wanted to give you the opposite of réduire, which is déglacer. Déglacer is the opposite of réduire for very often une sauce. Déglacer, déglace in English. You usually do that with water or wine. So you have a pan with some grease in it or residue of cooking, which are very tasty. You can add water or wine. And this is déglacer. Déglacer, it's the opposite of réduire because you add liquid to it. But it's only if you're into cooking. Okay, this was a lot of new vocabulary. Did you take good notes? It's okay to pause, come back, watch it again. You're absolutely fine. We're in no hurry. Okay, now let's test yourself with a quiz. How do you say to boil in French? To boil. How do you say to simmer? And how do you say to brown? To boil something is bouillir. Bouillir with the y sound in it. Bouillir. To simmer is mijoter. Mijoter. Do you remember? It was at the beginning of the lesson. Mijoter. And to brown is faire revenir. Faire revenir. If you're intermediate or advanced, you might remember that we have other verbs for that, but just remembering one is good enough for today. Faire revenir. So let's recap. What did you learn today? The 6 verbs, what were they? You had mijoter, mijoter, to simmer. Bouillir, to boil, bouillir. We had cuire au bain-marie, cuire au bain-marie. We had faire revenir, remember? And couvrir as a 5th verb, and I need my second hand, couvrir, to cover, and réduire, to reduce, réduire. So if you have all of those 6, it's fantastic. Well done. Et toi, partage le plat français que tu aimes cuisiner. Partage le plat français que tu aimes cuisiner. Please share your favorite French meal or dish that you love cooking in order to give ideas to students. That's a fantastic way to learn about new ideas for cooking. And please, if you can, post a link to the recipe you use. That would be very nice. For example, you can say, je fais souvent de la quiche Lorraine parce que ma petite fille adore ça. Voici la recette que j'utilise pour la cuisiner à la maison. Je fais souvent de la quiche Lorraine parce que ma petite fille adore ça. Voici la recette que j'utilise pour la cuisiner à la maison. I very often cook quiche Lorraine because my granddaughter loves it. This is the recipe I use to cook it at home. If you have any question about this lesson, please share it in the comment area as well. I love answering students' questions. If you want to go beyond this tiny lesson, please get my free 10-day everyday French crash course. It's an email course that lasts 10 days. It is completely free and it's pretty fun. It will help you double your French in just 10 days. How to get it? Go to Comme une Française and leave your first name and email and you will get access immediately. It is completely free. It's by email. It lasts 10 days. And if it's not for you, you can completely unsubscribe and not receive anything ever again from me. Join us. It's pretty fun. And again, it is free. If you like this lesson and you learned something today about French verb for cooking, please help me spread the word about Comme une Française. Share this lesson with a Francophile friend. You can use email, WhatsApp, text your best friend, tell them next time you see them, and even better, you can tell your French class about it. They might love to learn about French verb for cooking because they love cooking French food. Merci for taking the time to watch the Comme une Française French lesson. More and more students are learning French with Comme une Française. I hope to see you next Tuesday. À mardi prochain. I wish you une bonne journée, une bonne soirée maybe, or une bonne nuit if you're going to bed. And I will see you next time. Allez, salut!